practice. The first thing in every decision tree is a box. So we insert a box. We draw a rectangle.
Recently, FCG has approached Hitachi and they have shown a strong interest in purchase of our e-learning system. Matt, the account manager, has asked me to work on an estimate. Matt figures that if we submit a proposal for $150,000, there is a 25% probability that Hitachi will agree to the price, a 50% probability that a price of $120,000 would be eventually agreed to, and a 25% chance probability that Hitachi will simply refuse the offer. In further discussion with Matt, we determined that if we submit a proposal for $100,000, there is a 50% probability that Hitachi will accept this price, a 45% probability that they will bargain and we will agree to a price of $80,000, and a 5% probability that the customer will refuse the offer, no deal.
Okay. So what are the two options in front of us? No, basically, while you were reading, I realized that there are two options that we have. What are those? The question is that, after all, in this scenario, there are a number of things that we can do. Think about this. And actually, the decision is always about what we can do. Our decisions only influence our options and what we can do. Like, this is it's not a philosophical question. That's the nature of the decision. When we are faced with a decision, it means that there are more than one thing that we can do. So a prisoner in a prison has no decision to make regarding the location of living, because there is only one option, no decision about that. If you have two actions that you can do, or more than one action that you can do, then you have a decision to make.
There's two proposals.
Exactly, two proposals. One of them, proposal 150,000, and the other one is proposal, like basically we propose to provide a service at 100,000. Am I right? One was 150, one was 100,000. So we created the two entry points to our decision tree. These are basically, if there are three options, for example, usually there is also another option that, you know, we don't do anything. You know, this scenario doesn't highlight that, but there is always another option that we don't do anything. And the payoff of not doing anything is usually zero. Now, if we propose a 150,000 proposal, what are the possibilities? It seems to me that 25% chance, 50% chance, and 25% chance. So there are three possibilities. Now here we will add a circle. Okay. So from here on, what will happen to us is not certain. It's probabilistic. One possibility is that they accept our proposal. One is that they reject, they negotiate with us. And the other possibility is that they walk away. Now, what is the chance of each one of these? What is the chance of acceptance? Please read the scenario. No, we offer this 150,000 prize and they say, sure, we will do it. We will go, we will get it. The chance
25% is? 25%.
So how about we type 0.25? You can type 0.25 or you can type 25 and change that 25 to be formatted as a percentage. That doesn't matter. 25%, negotiate. Okay, let me make these lines a little. The longer we make the line, the more space we will have between the lines at the end. Negotiate. How much is the chance that they will negotiate if we offer 50,000?
50%.
50? Yeah. Okay, 50. So 0.5. And because we are showing everything as percentage, fine. And the chance that they will walk away would be, of course, 1 minus 25 minus 50 would be the rest. Okay. And this, the if this happens, how much money we will get? 150,000. They accepted our proposal, right? If they walk away, we will get zero. And if they accept with negotiation, what is the scenario say? If they negotiate, there is 50% chance that they will accept
120.
Very good. 120,000. So this is the different things that can happen with different probabilities if we offer 150,000. Now for the second, if you choose the second course of action, then there is also three possible scenarios. So if we offer 100,000 in our proposal, what is the chance of acceptance?
50%.
Very good. Because we are now offering a lower price, the chance of acceptance. Notice that I'm putting that, and I suggest you do that because later when we want to do calculations, we want to have the percentage in a separate cell. So 50% is the chance of acceptance. Then what is the other option?
45% is negotiate proposal.
Oh, negotiate. So there is still a possibility that they will negotiate. So if they negotiate, there is a chance 45%? Yeah.
Yes.
0.45. And what is the chance that they will walk away?
5%.
Because we are providing a good deal, the chance that they will walk away is 0.05. If you want to see it in percentage form, it is 5%. Now, if they accept it, of course, we will get our proposal, nothing more than that. If they walk away, we get zero. And if they negotiate, they will ask for something less, 80,000, for example. So this is expected monetary value of the decision that we are making, and obviously we will multiply 25% by 15,000 plus 50% multiplied by 120,000 plus 25% multiplied by a payoff of zero. This is the expected payoff of the first decision. Now let's calculate the expected monetary value for this decision. And we do the same thing. So there is 50% chance of this plus 45% chance of this payoff, plus 5% chance of this payoff. What would be our decision?
Proposal one?
Proposal $150,000 proposal, exactly. Because its expected monetary value is higher, then we will choose that one. Now, one of the questions is that what would happen if the acceptance rate would change? Like one of the questions that we may have is the sensitivity of our decision to these probabilistic estimates, because this is deterministic. This is one option. This is one another option. The payoffs and these probabilities, like this payoff is deterministic, this is deterministic, but this payoff and these probabilities are depends on our estimate. So let's assume that the chance of walk away is constant for simplicity. And let's assume that this 25%, if it goes down, the chance of negotiation will go up. And if the chance of acceptance goes up, the chance of negotiation goes down. So instead of this 50% to be a constant, I want you to change it to a probabilistic calculation. So the total, if 20% chance is the chance of walk away, the change in acceptance would change the chance of negotiation. So let's see. If the chance of acceptance goes up, this should go down. So this would be minus 0.75 minus whatever is the chance of acceptance. So it still shows 50%, but this time it depends on our acceptance. Let us practice with that. So for example, if the chance of acceptance becomes 0.3, the chance of negotiation becomes 0.45. If the chance of acceptance is 0.1, the chance of negotiation is 0.65. So let's change it to 0.25. And now you see that this is exactly the same thing that was shown before, but now it is dynamic. The chance of acceptance changes the chance of negotiation. And now we will check if this expected monetary value, how sensitive it is to this 25%. Now, if the chance of acceptance goes down, let's say from 25% to 10%, what is our decision?
I'm sorry, Amir, could you please show that again, how we did that?
The only thing that I changed is that I made this one depending on acceptance.
Yeah, exactly. So what does the 0.75 represent?
That is the total probability of acceptance of negotiation. Because if walk away has 25% chance, then the combination of acceptance and negotiation would have a 75% chance.
Okay.
Say something so I realize.
I think I understand.
Okay, very good. Okay, so now if this chance goes down, the chance of negotiation goes up, still the total is 1, 25 plus 65 plus 10 is 1, but our expected monetary value went down. However, what is our decision? What kind of proposal will we provide?
Still proposal 1.
Still proposal 1. Mm-hmm. Now, if there is no chance that they will accept it right away, what is our proposal?
Still proposal 1.
Exactly. So this is called sensitivity analysis. So notice that, we realize that if this is the case, if the chance of their walk away remains at 25%, then our decision is not sensitive to these probabilities, and we have to actually proposal 1 no matter what the probabilities are. Okay, so this in this decision model, which we assume that the chance of walk away remains at 25%, notice that walk away is the risk in this. And the rest of today's class, we will discuss this incorporation of the idea of the risk. But what is risky is not, you know, acceptance and negotiation. What is risky for us is what if they simply walk away, okay? So if it was, if the model of thinking, if the reality could be modeled like this, our decision is actually not sensitive to the chance of acceptance, okay? So now let's make our model a little more complicated. Let's change this to 0.25, and let's this remain constant. And let's make this model a little more complicated. This 0.75 was 1 minus the chance of walk away. So 1 minus the chance of walk away minus the chance of acceptance gives the chance of negotiation. Okay. So now we are incorporating in our formula the chance of walk away and the chance of acceptance. Now let's say, let's assume that acceptance is 25%, and let's think about this. Notice that it is still one total. Now what will happen if the chance of 25% becomes 10%, okay? The chance of walk away goes down, then and the chance of acceptance is still 20%. Look, expected monetary value is so good. Now we have to still propose 150,000. But if the chance of walk away goes to 40%, what is our decision now?
Proposal two.
So you see, it is actually the chance of walk away that we are sensitive to. If the chance of walk away increases, then, and assuming the chance of acceptance is the same, then we are very sensitive to this. If we go to 0.35, then still the decision is 2. Only if the chance is 0.3, that our choice is proposal one. So the question is that how sensitive we are to walk away. We are very sensitive. And what is that break-even point? To find out what is the break-even point, there are multiple different ways. I show you one of the ways that is suggested to be done. I want you to click on your data tab and look at under analyze whether or not you have solver. So you go to file, go to options. There is a window pop up in front of me. Do you see it?
Yes.
Yeah.
So my pop up is visible to you. Very good. So go to add-ins and choose analysis tool pack. And in Excel, add-ins here should be selected. Click go. Mine already is selected. I have selected everything except Euro currency tools. You can do the same thing. Okay, and then click OK and so forth. Then when you come back, you should see solver. We want to find out what is this value where the expected monetary value of the first proposal becomes close to the second one. So we go to solver. We want, our objective is to make cell C4 to become the value of 86,000. By changing we want the system to try all possible values of the walk away and tell us what value of walk away the expected monetary value becomes. This 91,500 becomes 86,000. And then we click on solve. And it says, do you want to keep it? We'll say yes. Keep solver solution. So the break-even point is 34.58. Okay. So how about we write it here? Break-even chance of walk away is 34.58%. Okay, let's create the table like this. We'd say these are the walk away probabilities. So here we write the walk away probability. And in front of it, we will write the payoff or expected monetary value. And for different values of this, we will find out for point one, the expected monetary value is 115,500. For point two, it is 105,500. For point three, let's calculate that, would be 91,500. And point four, it is 79,500 and point, okay, let's go to one. So what would be one, okay? And for one, it would be, one cannot be one, that's the problem. What is the maximum that it can be? The maximum it can be is, okay, let's go to 0.5. There is a maximum. You cannot go to 1.5. This would be 67,500. If we go 0.6, this would be 55,512. And 4.7, this will be 435,200. Can it be 0.8? It cannot be 0.8 because one, did you see, this becomes negative. So these are all of the possible values in the range that we are interested in. And to see how the sensitivity is, we will select this range. We go to insert, scatter diagram, and this is how this works. And actually we can add the trend line. So this is the slope. And as you can see, we were interested in 86,000. So somewhere around here, this curve, that expected monetary value of the first choice goes below the expected monetary value of the second alternative that we have. And that was actually at 34. We found it exactly, but now we are visualizing it. Now, to another way that we can think of sensitivity is that how much sensitive our expected monetary value is to each increment of this, or what is the slope of this line? Let's do that and go to the break. If we want to know how sensitive this line is to a change in this percentage. So let's say for 1%, we can calculate the slope of the line. So the slope is, you can choose any 2 points. So for example, is equal to this minus this. So this is how much it goes down. Oh, actually it should be negative. So let's do that. Second point minus the first point divided by second probability minus the first probability. I have to add parentheses. But we want per, you know, per 1%. So we will divide it by 100. So it seems that for every percent that we go down, you know, from 10% to 11% to 12%, our utility or expected monetary value goes down by 1200. This is how sensitive it is. So this is a more precise way of thinking about sensitivity as the slope of this line. For every percent that the chance of walk away increases, the chance of expected monetary value payoff goes down by $1,200. And of course, if it goes down by 35%, then it will be below 86,000 and so forth. So three way of thinking about sensitivity. Finding the break event value of the probability. Method two, visualizing it as a line that is changing our utility or expected monetary value based on the changes in probability. And actually looking at the slope is the exact amount of sensitivity per every percentage of change in the probability. I'm showing you the slope is the change in Y, change in monetary value, divided by change in your probability.
Yeah, but why did we calculate this?
Oh, because this slope shows us, you know, if the slope of this line, if this line would end up to be like this. Then we were very sensitive to change of probability. If the probability would change a little bit, our expected monetary will fall a lot. So this slope is more than this. Therefore, this line is more sensitive to change in probability. And the other possibility is that our line will end up to have a very tiny slope. And if it has tiny slope like this, then it means that if this probability changes, our expected monetary value doesn't change very much. So the slope of this line is a measure of sensitivity. That's why we are interested in this slope.
Okay. Thank you, Amir.
My pleasure. And now let's go back to the original scenario, point 25. But you all should admit that this proposal one is very risky. So when you, if you are the business owner, you think to yourself, look, this is, there is 25% chance that I will get nothing. While if I go with the second option, the chance that I will get nothing is 5%. So if you are a company who needs actually to make money, then you have to think about considering the risk. Now, to include risk in our probability analysis, a new construct is created, and that construct is called the utility. So follow me while we are going to extract the utility for this company, the utility function, okay? To the maximum payoff possible, we assign a utility of 1, and to the minimum payoff, we assign a utility of 0. Then I want you to imagine that if you get a $80,000 profit out of Hitachi, how happy you will be in this range from 150,000 to zero? How happy will you be if you get 120,000? How happy you will be if you get 100,000 and 80,000, okay? So just imagine that if this is one, how much would be your utility if you get 1,200? Would it be 90%? Would it be 80%? Would it be half happiness? How much happy you will be if you get, instead of 150,000, if you get 120,000 out of this proposal? Tell me. You will have different opinions, but just tell me what is your opinion. If you earn 150,000 and that the amount of happiness that you get is one, how much would be your happiness if you get a contract of 120,000 after negotiations?
0.8.
Yeah, it is less than one for sure. Mm-hmm. But okay, so you think that your utility will go down by 20%? Okay, let's think about that. So you go 80%. And how much will be your utility if you get 100,000?
I don't know, probably 0.5, like down by half.
0.5, okay. And for 80,000? Okay. So, okay, to put you in that situation, what we do is that we propose a game, a lottery. So imagine that you have one option to grab 120,000, and the other option that you have is that you go to a lottery which has a chance of 90% of winning 150,000 and 10% chance of winning zero. Which one will you choose? And the other option that you have is 120,000, okay? Now I want everybody to think about this. Which one will you choose? A guaranteed 120,000 or 90% chance of 150,000? And 10% chance that you will get nothing. So it's like deal or no deal game that we are playing. Which one will you choose? Basically, the game deal or not deal, if you have seen it, it's a game of extracting the utility of the person. If the TV show knows your utility, they can manipulate you very well. If not, they can extract your utility by, listening to your answers to these offers. Anyone, which one do you choose?
Okay, let me choose. 90 or 150,000?
Yeah, between 120,000 and this deal, which one do you choose? Okay, if this is hard, okay, let me make it easier. 0.5, 0.5. Okay, I give you 120,000 for sure, or you enter in a lottery that there is 50% chance that you will win 150,000. Which one do you take? If you choose the lottery, this means that you are a risk taker. And there is nothing wrong with that. So, people who are in stock market, people who are in business, in different kinds of business, some of them are conservative players and some of them are risk takers. Now, I want to know those who will choose a 50-50 deal of a lottery winning 150 instead of grabbing 120,000 for sure. These are your least risk taker friends. No, nobody is risk taker. Okay, I changed the deal. 60% chance versus 40% chance of zero. Who will take this deal? You have 60% chance of winning 150, 40% chance of zero compared to a guaranteed 120,000. Who will take the yellow lottery?
I think it's with the amount. If you increase the amount, probably someone...
No, we only play with probability. Okay? Notice that this 150 is dictated by the decision-making situation. I just want to measure your utility function, and we will draw that later. We want to identify your utility function, and based on that, we will realize how much risk taker you are. Notice that if it was just expected monetary value, this session would be done. But in expected monetary value, the psychology of risk-taking of the individual or the capacity of risk-taking for a corporation is not calculated. If you are, let's say, Microsoft, you would take the chance because 120,000 is nothing for you, 60% chance of 150. You know, sure, the worst case is that I don't get anything. If you really, if 120,000 makes a lot of change in your life, then you would take the... So it depends to a number of things. One is the psychology of risk-taking. The other is the capacity of risk-taking. And we don't know beforehand what is the situation for the company you are a consultant for, or the person that you are helping to make a decision, the manager that is making this decision. So... this 150 is part of the deal. We cannot change that. But by this lottery, by increasing the chance of you winning 150, I can understand whether you are a risk taker or not. So what about this deal? 0.7 and 0.3. Who will take 100? Who will take the lottery instead of 120? Raise your hand. No one. Okay, I change it to 0.8 and 0.2. Who will take the lottery now? Two people. These are people who are risk taker, but we don't have the majority yet. Okay, so let's go with 0.9. Let's say you are the board of directors and we want to make a decision. This will not get the vote. Who will take this deal now? Instead of grabbing 120,000, we'll accept a deal like this, 90% chance of 150 and 10% chance of nothing. Raise your hand if you accept this. Okay. More people are raising their hand. Still, we don't have a real majority. So I change my, this is the game that you have to play for every point. So don't imagine that we are playing it once. We're going to play for every data point that we want. So now we are playing a lottery of 95% chance of getting 150,000 and getting 120,000 for sure. No one? Okay, anyone else? No, okay. So I change it to 98% and 2%. Those who take this lottery and not the 120,000 for sure. Who will get this lottery instead of 100? Please raise your hand. Okay, who will take 0.99 and 1% chance of nothing? Who will take this deal? Okay, who will take this deal? 150,000. And no chance of losing compared to 100. Who will take the lottery now? Okay, please raise your hand if you take the lottery now.
It's 150K, like 100% chance?
Yes. Okay. Those who take the lottery, please raise your hand. Now, please, everybody, please bring your hand down. We will start from here. 0.9. And 0.1, we are interested in the 0.120,000, and we want to find the equivalent utility for that. So who will take this yellow deal instead of 120,000? Please raise your hand. Okay, that's definitely the majority. Let's go 0.85 and 0.15. If you still take the deal, keep your hand up. Otherwise, bring your hand down if the deal is not exciting for you anymore. 0.85 is about 50-50. Okay, so this seems for our class, notice that this is different than the utility function that is in the question, but that's fine. For our class, it seems to be 0.85. Yeah, 0.851, okay, the way that we calculated is that the utility of 50,000 is 1, the utility of 0 is 0. So to let me calculate this to be 1 minus 0.85. So for 0.85, the expected utility or the value of the utility that we calculate for 1200 is 0.85 multiplied by 1 plus 0.15 multiplied by 0. So utility is 0.85. So we found one utility. The utility for payoff of 120,000 for our board of directors is 85, okay? So ready, let's do another game. Now we need to find out for 100,000, okay? Everybody, please bring your hand down. Dear board of directors, we start from 0.5.
Okay. Amir, can you quickly show the utility calculation? Oh, never mind, it's good, I got it. It's on the screen right now. Yeah, I'm good, thank you.
Okay, and also change this to 1 minus M24, so then we don't have to change a lot of things every time. So a new lottery. Our lottery is 50% just chance of getting 150 and 50% chance of nothing. So those who take this lottery, instead of $100,000 guaranteed, please raise your hand. Nobody. Can I change it to 0.6? Who will take 0.6 chance of 150,000 compared to 100,000? 0.7, not many people. 0.75 chance of 150 compared to 100. So there is 3/4 chance that you will get 150 compared to 100,000. If you take the deal, please raise your hand. Okay, 0.8. Those who take this deal, please raise your hand. 0.8. You have 80% chance of winning 150 compared to getting 100,000 for sure. Okay, we go to 0.85. Those who take 0.85, chance of 150 compared to 100,000 cash. Who is winning to get 0.90 chance of 150? Compared to, okay, so now it's, oh, so 0.90. How about 0.85? If you don't take the deal for 0.85, bring your hand down. 0.85 chance of 150 compared to 100. So those who are raising their hand, it means that they will take the lottery of 85% chance of 150 compared to 100,000. Okay. Now, 0.8, bring your hand down if you don't take the lottery and 100,000 compared to 100,000 cash. Okay, a lot of people don't take 180. So, okay, hey, let's go with 0.825 or even 0.83. There is nothing wrong with that. So if it is 100,000, then the utility would be 83. Now let's go for 80,000.
Amir, could you show the calculation for utility once?
question. It's the probability of winning multiplied by 1 plus probability of losing multiplied by 0.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, and the reason I chose 0.83 is that, you know, 0.80 was less than majority, 0.85 was more than majority, so a little bit less than 0.85. So basically your utility doesn't go down, you know, from 120. So basically there's not that much difference in your utility if you get 120,000 guarantee or 100,000 guarantee. Now let's go with 80,000. Everybody, please bring your hand down. Another game. We have to play a game of lottery for every point. Who will take a deal of 50% chance of 150,000 and instead of $80,000 cash? So we'll go to 0.6. Who will take a lottery of 0.60% chance of 150,000 compared to 80,000. 150,000 with 60% chance, 40% chance of nothing. 0.7, 70% chance of getting 150,000, 30% chance of nothing compared to $80,000 cash. Not majority, 0.8, 80% chance of getting 150,000 compared to 80,000 cash. Now the majority is getting the deal. Okay, so let's go to 0.75. Those who take the deal of 0.75% chance of 150, 25% chance of nothing compared to 80,000 cash. Keep your hand up that if you still accept the lottery. It seems that 0.75 is half. So what happened? Okay. So 0.75 is the utility of 80,000. And do we have any other point? No, we don't have any other point. We can play this game. We can continue play this game. But the utility of zero payoff would be zero. And actually, this is enough for us to draw the curve. Let me put the payoff as the second column. It's better to, it's easier if you put the payoff in the second column. And now we draw the utility function of your class. The reason that we say you are risk averse because this curve is concave compared to this line. See, this is a concave curve. You know, once, you know, at first the slope is high, but when we get close to the 100,000, 80,000, 100,000 and so forth, then your utility doesn't change that much, which is expected to be like this, okay? So listen, the drawing a utility curve through a set of lotteries by itself is an important task. Now that we know the utility that people get considering the risk, we can go back to our tree. And now we can calculate our expected utility instead of expected monetary value. The utility of 120,000 is 0.85. The utility of zero is zero. The utility of 100,000 is 0.83. The utility of 80,000 is 0.75. And now we can calculate expected utility. And expected utility is different than expected monetary value because it calculates it includes the risk. So the expected utility of the first decision would be 25% probability of getting a utility of 1 plus 50% probability of getting a utility of 0.85 plus 25% probability of getting a utility of zero. Now let's calculate the expected utility of the second decision. I do it here, expected utility. Let's make it red and bold, red and bold. And let's make all of the utilities red and bold also. So we know that they are related. Here, I would say the expected utility of the second decision, 50% chance of getting a utility of 83% plus 45% chance of getting a utility of 75% plus 5% chance of getting no utility. Now a question. Considering the kind of risk-averse people that you are, and you didn't want to accept any risk, we would become happy only if the chance of winning was more than 75%. So you are risk-averse people. Now, the expected utility, tell us the utility that you have, considering your risk-taking nature, or next risk-taking capacity. Also, it can be related to the situation of your company. So now, what is your decision? Will you send a proposal one or proposal two?
Proposal two?
So, yes. So notice that when we ignored the expected utility, we ignored the risk, your choice was proposal one with an expected monetary value of 97,500. However, now that the risk is getting involved in our calculations, you will propose the second one. Basically, in your mind, it says that, look, I'm not going to accept, you know, I'm not the kind of person, considering this utility function that I have, that accepts a chance of 25% of loss and I'm getting nothing. I'm not that kind of person. So this one gives me a 5% chance of nothing. I will take that risk compared to this one. So you would choose the second option. Very good. Now, what if we change this 25% to 0.20? So the risk of choosing the first proposal is less now, right?
Yeah.
So now it is 20%. Will you choose proposal one or proposal two?
Still two.
If the chance of not, you know, the chance of walk away, the risk of the first proposal goes down and they really love us for some reason, will you choose proposal one or proposal two?
Still two?
No. Now, proposal one has an expected utility of 0.76, while proposal two has an expected utility of 0.725. We can actually do another solver question. What would be the risk of the first proposal at which the two proposals will have the same expected utility? Notice that the first proposal gives us a chance of winning 150 and 120, while the second proposal has low risk, but low payoff as well. So there is a walk away percentage that makes the two proposals equally interesting for us. A little bit risk in the first option, considering a little bit more payoff in the first option, a very low risk in the second option, with very low payoff in the second option. At some point, the payoff of the two utility functions will become the same. So